I love this.
You guys gotta go to Winter Music Conference with that.
Yo ya estoy puesta para la rumba.
Guys, talk about a fusion. We have Mexican Dubwiser here in the house. All right, you guys know what to do. Ready? One, two, three. Wow!
All right.
Now, first of all, this guy, he's such a character. He's also part of one of my favorite bands, Kinky. So tell me, you know, what you're trying to explore and experiment with Mexican Dubwiser as far as the sounds that we're listening to. Obviously, it's a lot of dance music, but you have all the elements kicking. What's
going on? Yeah, Mexican Dubwiser started in like 2009 when we as a project, this band that is combining and fusion music that Marcelo and myself enjoy a lot. It's like reggae, dub, R&B, electronic, of course, hip hop. And a lot of Mexican music, like roots, norteño, cumbia, banda, and stuff like that. Marcelo and I, we really enjoy that music. And we just started doing that as a team, and suddenly we are in our third album right now.
Wow. ¿Es esto por esta razón se les llama, les dicen la Revolución Sónica?
Pues tiene, porque el primer disco se llamaba Revolution Radio.
Okay.
Y sí tiene, it has to do a little bit about trying to explore and push boundaries, and also talk about a little bit of about unity on the world, and trying to make it a better place for everybody.
¿De dónde sale el nombre Dubwiser? Porque yo vi el nombre y yo dije Budweiser, no, es Dubwiser.
Dubwiser.
Sí, ¿de dónde sale? ¿Qué significa?
Bueno, dub music.
It's a play on words. Is it on Budweiser or something else?
No, well, like dub being like dub music, okay. And Weiser, you know, more. And okay. The project is kind of like mashups of, you know, different style of music.
Yeah. Awesome.
So it was kind of like a little...
Listen, Dennis listens to Taylor Swift and Miley Cyrus. He knows nothing of dub. Although maybe Miley Cyrus knows dub.
I've dubbed a telenovela, actually.
Okay, yes. It's a whole different
kind
of dub.
I do know a little
bit about it.
But Dennis was dancing the song, so that's all that matters. Yeah.
That's all that matters.
That's all that matters.
And it's true, you bring people together with the music. Sometimes people don't even know what they're listening to, but it's like, oh, I like this sound.
Exactly.
I want to know where it comes from and listen, you know, and then they find out more about music, and then like that's what you're saying is the unity that you can create with just one song is amazing.
Exactly, exactly.
No, y con el pasito este que tú haces, Marcela, ¿cómo era? Me encanta, o sea, digo, no sé ni cómo hacerle, pero... Y me faltan los lentes. La próxima vez que venga de Zoo, I'm gonna wear glasses like you guys, and I'm not gonna let anybody see my face, and I'm just gonna, like, dub it.
So the music video para el sencillo que acaban de sacar, eso fue filmado en un hospital de loco, ¿fue?
Well, it's a recreation.
Oh, okay, because I thought it was a real, like, asylum.
I mean...
No, well, no, no, una cosa es un asylum y una cosa es un hospital de locos.
¿No es la misma
manicomio,
cosa?
Manicomio, manicomio. ¿Qué fue? ¿Manicomio, hospital o asilo, güey? Porque la verdad es que estoy bien confundido.
Yo creo que todos son la misma cosa. Son, there's different degrees.
No, asilo es para viejitos. Manicomio es para gente que
but in English, asylum has a totally different... the one for viejitos in English is nursing home.
Do you see how this conversation... And you thought you were just going to talk about the album. Are you guys touring or performing anywhere that people can catch you in the next few months?
Yeah, we're going to be touring a lot during the rest of the year. We're going to be in Mexico a lot. Also here in the state, we're planning a tour in September and a couple of shows still in during the summer. So, but most... Check out our web pages and stuff, Mexican Dubwiser on Facebook.
And we can also find you on Spotify, right?
Yeah, Spotify, the album is out already.
Yes.
It's called Border Frequency. You were just listening to the single, a song we did with Tito Fuentes from Molotov.
It's a
really cool collaboration.
How often do people walk up to you and say, you're in Molotov, right?
Yeah,
you're in
you get
confused?
Yeah, I get confused sometimes, yeah.
Do the guys in Molotov know that people think that you're just like this, because people see you, you know, and then they kind of like, oh, what band is he in? Especially here in America where... You know, maybe they're not as familiar with certain bands.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but, just like, I can be a guy too. So.
He's like, I'll be whoever you want me to be.
Today. Y la gente que va a los shows usualmente son latinas, son americanos que también le gustan este sonido.
It's very interesting because the sound of Mexican Dubwiser is a little bit very international. We call it like a global party.
Yeah. Okay.
So we've been to England to the Glastonbury Festival. We just did Vive Latino on March And then also we had a great special invitation to the World Havana Music Festival in Cuba.
Oh, wow.
We just did that last a couple of weeks ago. We were in Cuba in this amazing festival, free for
best
the people.
The best crowd dancing that you saw in all your shows, the best dancing crowd and audience had to be the people in Cuba, right? They were just... Yeah. They were shaking their rumps.
Yes. Yeah.
You need a manual and somebody to spot you to do some of the moves that these kids do in Cuba.
They are dancing even if they're just walking to their
street. That's
true. That's
Humberto
here in the hallway.
It's the momentum of the butts. I don't have a Cuban butt. It's the one Cuban thing I don't have, but like it's the momentum of the butts.
Exactly. Everybody's dancing in Cuba. It's amazing. It's an amazing special country.
Do you guys are more here or in Monterrey? Or you go back and forth? Like you're based in LA or based in Monterrey?
In LA. Based in LA.
Take over LA.
So, of course, also the song called Lecture Me, it has this amazing MC from Los Angeles called Self Provoke. We just saw him on the video. He's an amazing MC. So it's a great combination. So guys from Monterrey with Molotov and some MC from LA. So it's an amazing track and the response has been great with that track.
So you're starting tour in the summer, you're starting in Mexico and then you're coming to the US?
Yes, in September in the US.
Awesome. September in the US. And when are you starting Mexico? Just to know.
Right, when the release party is in June, right?
June, okay. Perfect.
We're getting cut off, so
fantastic.
The name of the album?
Border Frequency, it's out already. Mexican Dubweiser, check it out. And then single is called Lecture Me.